Friends, welcome to SEED Technology Certificate course. Here I'll be dealing with the topic SEED Pathology, Diseases and Injury. We are all aware that SEED Pathology is an integral part of SEED Technology, and this subject generally deals with diseases, injury, causal agents, predisposing factors, SEED quarantine, SEED health testing, and many more. So this is basically on the topic diseases and injury. As we all know that seed is a living entity playing an important role in agriculture sector, it can inevitably be a vehicle of pathogen. It can carry pathogen with or without being diseased, and it can be a victim of detriments other than diseases. A very good example is the insect damage. A disease is a factor that interferes with normal functions of a particular organism. In case of seed, disease is a factor that interferes with the normal functions or the structure of the seed. Here, it is classified into two types, physiogenic diseases and the biogenic diseases. Physiogenic diseases deals with the environmental factors like the variation of the temperature, humidity, then the presence of chemicals, more or less chemicals. And in case of biogenic, it deals with the pathogens like the virus, bacteria, insects, fungi. Injury is the damage to the structure of the plant brought about by the physical, chemical, or animal force, wounding, mechanical injury, such as harvesting, processing, cleaning, transportation, insect injury, or the frost injury. Ultimately, due to this injury, the seeds can be prone to diseases. In the earlier slides, we had come across the term physiogenic disease. This physiogenic disease deals with unfavorable environmental conditions such as variation in temperature, humidity, and chemicals. Now, deficiency disease is due to the chemicals. Chemicals such as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, etc. One example selected here is deficiency of nitrogen. In case of wheat, nitrogen deficiency can cause yellow berry of wheat. The kernels of wheat show the yellow spots as symptoms, which are rich in starch but devoid of protein. Now, why deficiency in protein? Protein is made up of amino acids, and amino acid structure has an element nitrogen. So, if no nitrogen, protein deficiency is obvious. Application of nitrates can control this physiogenic disease. Opting crop rotation process by growing leguminous crops or pulses such as kidney beans, green gram. These consist of root nodule bacteria which assist in fixing of nitrogen. Temperature is an important influencing factor on the predisposition of seeds towards readiness of the pathogen causing disease. Dry seeds usually withstand extremely low temperature, but wet seeds get killed below 0 degrees. This will reduce or destroy the viability of seed, leading to frost damage. Mustard. The fruit of mustard is called the silica. Now, silica looks normal outside, but the seeds inside are brown, shrunken, and dried up. This is a prevailing physiogenic disease in the northern European countries. Likewise, if you look at the high temperature also can cause changes in the viability of seed and the germination capacity. A good example is the hot water treatment, one of the physical treatments. So when the seeds are subjected to the hot water treatment, there may be reduction of the germination capacity. The next thing is self-heating. Self-heating is due to the moisture content of the storage crops. So when the seeds are in the stored forms and the moisture content increases, there is chances of respiration. So when this respiration takes place, there is changes in the fatty acids, especially of the oily seeds, and also the biochemical constituents, which can further attract the pathogens. Based on the lifespan of the seed under storage condition, the seeds can be classified as orthodox seeds and the recalcitrant seeds. Orthodox seeds are the long-lived seeds and can be successfully dried to moisture contents as low as 5% without any injury and are able to tolerate freezing. Orthodox seeds are thus also termed as desiccation-tolerant seeds. Examples are the guava seeds, tomato seeds, and the peas. Coming to recalcitrant seeds, these are quite opposite to that of orthodox seeds, and these seeds cannot withstand high temperature or low temperature, so it's a very difficult task during the ex situ conservation, and more research is going on in these aspects. Good example is the jackfruit seeds and the mango seeds. Chemical damage to the seed is common because of the overdoses of the chemicals such as insecticide, herbicide, weedicide, and pesticides. Also, during the seed storage process, there is application of fumigants. Here, with the overdoses of the chemicals, the prevailing condition of the seed could be more and more toxic. Formaldehyde treated seed sown immediately might not reduce the germination process. However, formaldehyde treated seed sown after few hours or sown after a long run storage can hinder the germination process as the chemical formaldehyde converts to paraformaldehyde, which is toxic. Plant hormones are indeed phenomenal. It plays a significant role in physiological process of seed, but overdoses may hinder the process of germination. For instance, 2,4-D. Now this 2,4-D is an auxin which has wide application as herbicides. Seed pathology is a science that deals with microorganisms infecting the seeds. So the seeds are attacked by various types of microorganisms. It can be a nematode, it can be a fungi, bacteria, virus, and these can attack at any stages of the seeds. So when the seed is in the mother plant itself, it can be attacked by a pathogen. During the seed processing stages, like the harvesting, threshing, cleaning, upgrading, during winnowing process or drying process, there may be chances of the admixtures present in it. And during the seed storage process also, there may be chances of the attack by the pathogen. And also at the time of transportation or the seed marketing process, there is attack by the pathogens. Let's move on to biogenic diseases, seed-borne virus. Selected example is the familiar virus, TMV, or tobacco mosaic virus. Tobacco mosaic virus can attack tobacco host as well as the other strains of tobacco virus can attack tomato or pepper. Here, the main symptoms of the seeds are based on the color, where the seeds turn black. Now, if you assume that seeds may have chances of the tobacco mosaic virus, just dip your hands in milk during transplantation, or the plant bed sown with seeds can be sprayed with milk. Here, the proteins of the milk can rapidly inactivate the TMV. Seed disease caused by bacteria. Example is the bean crop host. Now, this bean crop host can be attacked by the pathogen Pseudomonas fasciolicola, causing yellow blight of beans. The symptoms are the black or brown necrotic spots surrounded by yellow halos, which is yellow chlorotic tissue. During the formation of the halo lesions, there is the formation of bacterial toxin called as fasciolotoxin. Seed disease caused by fungi. Fungi are ubiquitous in nature and can be present in seed as pathogens or storage fungi, releasing enormous toxins which are at times beneficial, but most of the times these mycotoxins are harmful basically to both plants and animals. An important foolish seedling disease, or the Bakane disease in rice, showing excessive growth of the stem apparently caused by the hormone gibberellic acid, is produced by the fungus Gibberella fusicori. Ergot of cereals caused by Claviceps species, this disease decreases the viability of the seed, producing alkaloids causing alkotism in humans consuming the grains contaminated with its fruiting body. However, the ergot alkaloids, ergotamines, are used in the treatment of migraine, showing some beneficial aspects of ergot. Coming to aflatoxins. Aflatoxins are carcinogenic toxins secreted by the fungus Aspergillus flavus, a storage fungi on crops. Here in this picture, you can find green colony of the fungus growing on groundnut. Seed disease caused by nematode. Nematode belongs to animal kingdom. So just imagine wheat, considered as vegetarian diet, consumed mixed with nematodes would make us, of course, uncertainly a non-vegetarian. Any wheat seeds turn black due to the presence of nematode should be avoided. The pathogen here is Anguina triticae, causing wheat kernels to resemble to that of peppercorn. The disease is ear cockle of wheat or peppercorn disease. Seeds can be victim of detriments such as insect damage. We have come across seeds without embryos or seeds without endosperms, seed pits or seed holes. Seed pitting or stigmatosis is due to insects. Examples are the Liguus bugs, which feed on the seed, forming irregular craters in the cotyledons. Although disease is an inevitable process, treatments can help to manage disease. Fundamentally, there are three methods: physical treatments, such as hot water treatment, dry heat treatment, aerated steam or solar heat treatment; chemical treatments, such as pelleting or spraying of chemicals or seed priming; then biological seed treatment using the biological controls, which are antagonistic in nature, like the bacteria Rhizobium or the fungi Trichoderma or neem plant as an insecticide. Then what is the seed disinfectants? Seed disinfectants refers to the eradication of the pathogen that penetrates within the seed. Seed disinfestation refers to the eradication of the pathogens on the surface of the seed. And seed protection is treatment as precautionary measure to avoid the attack of the pathogens. What are the effects of seed infection? The germination percentage gets reduced. Due to changes in the morphology of the seed, the market level can drastically get reduced. Due to the seed infection, there is changes in the content of the seed, so it will add on to different taste. Due to infection, it can also induce the secretion of toxic chemicals such as aflatoxin, which is carcinogenic. Seed pathology subject has lots of applications in seed quarantine, seed health, and research. Here, majority of the information is referred from the seed pathology textbook by Paul Neergaard. If you want to stay healthy, sow healthy seeds in your garden and eat healthy food. Thank you.